Okay, Michael, so we've gone on a journey of discovery through unsupervised learning. And so my question to you is, what have we learned?
I think we learned a little bit about ourselves.
And a little bit about America. So what A's have we learned today, Michael?
So there was PCA.
Mm-hmm.
ICA.
Mm-hmm.
LDA.
Mm-hmm.
RCA. And USA.
USA, we're number one. Woo! Okay, we're just going to erase that a little bit. Okay, yeah, okay, so we learned about a lot of A's today, which is the same grade that all our students are going to get, I'm sure.
That would be great.
Or that's if they're truly independent. If they aren't independent, then the central limit theorem says there will be a normal distribution across grades.
Ring that bell curve.
Ah, yeah, baby. Okay, so we learned about PCA, ICA, LDA, and RCA. What else did we learn about?
Well, I think that was it. But we talked about specifically, we talked in detail about the relationships between some of these.
Mm-hmm.
In particular, these are all examples of feature transformation.
That's right. Okay, so we found about the relationships between different transformation analysis. Oh, here's something we learned. We learned that the A doesn't just stand for analysis in the algorithms, but it actually does stand for analysis of the data.
Because that's unsupervised learning.
That's right. And that in particular, I gave some examples where ICA tells you what the underlying structure of the data is. You can use it to find structure. So that, for example, the independent components of natural scenes are edges.
So it's interesting because I feel like the other time that you emphasized structure was when you were talking about MIMIC, which was a piece of work that you did when you were a graduate student.
Yep.
One would almost want to guess that maybe you worked on ICA when you were a graduate student.
I actually did. My very first paper as a young graduate student was on MIMIC, and my very last paper as a young graduate student, my actual dissertation, was on independent components analysis.
I had that sense from the number of strong points that you felt the need to make about ICA.
Well, listen, man, really, structure runs my life. As you know, everything about my life is well-structured.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, did we learn anything else?
So, I feel like we spent a lot of time talking about, ICA is a more probabilistic kind of modeling method, and PCA is a more, I want to say, linear algebraic modeling model.
That's a really good point, Michael. So we didn't say it explicitly this way, but actually, even in our own work, it often comes up that sometimes you want to think about information theory, you want to think about probability, and sometimes you really just want to think about linear algebra. And you could see PCA as being really about linear algebra, and sometimes only coincidentally being about probability, whereas ICA is all about probability and information theory, and only coincidentally ever about linear algebra.
Yeah, that's helpful. That does seem to be a fundamental split in a lot of work that happens in machine learning.
Yeah, and it makes some sense. I mean, we know what the right answer is in probability, but we know what the right answer is in linear algebra. And I guess it's often the case, Michael, would you agree that the linear algebra approach is often easier to think about or easier to do in practice? I mean, sometimes can be interpreted as if it's probabilities. And that typically breaks down on the edge cases, but, you know, you can kind of work around it for to sort of common cases.
Yeah, that the linear algebra algorithms are often cheaper to execute, less prone to local minima issues. There's sort of a well-defined answer that they're finding, but it's often not quite the answer that you want. And the probability methods give you the answer that you want, but can be very hard to find.
Right, and in fact, you can see that in ICA and PCA, in that PCA is very well understood. There are lots of fast algorithms for it, and you know that the principal components always exist. Interestingly, we didn't talk about this, but by contrast, ICA, with its more information theoretic and probabilistic roots, has a very specific model, and it isn't always the case that model fits. And so, in fact, sometimes you can't find independent components because they don't actually exist, except in the most trivial sense. So it's both more expensive because of the way you end up searching the space, and it doesn't always produce an answer. But when it does produce an answer, it tends to produce very satisfying ones.
Well, I think that's a good place to stop in the sense that I wanted to know just one more interesting fact about ICA. And now that I've got that, I feel fully satisfied.
Well, there's another fact I can tell you, which is that it's the only one of these algorithms that start with a vowel.
And now I'm more than satisfied.
It is always my goal to leave you more than satisfied, Michael.
All right, then.
Okay, well, I think we are done with this entire sub-lesson mini course thingy.
About unsupervised learning. Well, that's great. What does that leave us to do?
Doesn't leave us to do anything, at least not with this particular mini course. I think actually the description we had here of what we've learned for this particular lesson actually applies even going backwards to some of our other lessons. And what we're going to get to do next is decision problems and reinforcement learning.
Ooh, exciting.
It is exciting.
But I think first people probably have some homeworky stuff to do, projects to do in the context of this mini course.
Yes, and probably an exam of some sort.
So good luck to everyone on that.
Yes, we're absolutely sure you'll do fine. Be sure to go over these lessons and be sure to read all of the material because there's a lot of detail in the material that wouldn't make a lot of sense for us to cover in this format. But do give it a read. Come back. Look at the stuff that we've talked about. It should help you to understand the intuition behind what's really happening there.
Excellent. Well, this is great. Thanks, Charles. I learned a lot.
Okay, I did too. Bye, Michael. I will hear from you soon.
All right. Awesome.
Bye.